BPM, bullets per minute, is a self-described rhythm action FPS roguelike. And while that may sound like a mix of buzzwords and genres of video games, the combination of these things is actually pretty awesome. So think of a fast-paced action FPS like Doom or Wolfenstein or something like that, but with a more technical aspect of a rhythm game. So to start, I'm showing you just a little bit of the early gameplay just to emphasize how this game completely broke my brain when I started to play it. So you can see in the middle of the screen where the crosshair is, there's some special UI to show you the tempo of the game, and most of the actions you do in this game have to go along with the beat of the music. So if you don't fire your gun to the beat of the game, it's actually not going to fire at all. This gets even more crazy when you have to reload to the beat, where sometimes, depending on the weapon, there's a multi-stage process for the reload. The basic gun that you start with is two stages, so you have to click the R button on PC twice in order to reload, with both presses needing to be to the beat. Other weapons may require a more involved reload, like the revolver requires you to press for each bullet. You can also do a pulse forward, but again, it's required to be to the beat. Your jumping and movement, though, are all whatever you want to do, so you can hop around to your heart's desire. So where this gets interesting is that while you may have done all of these mechanics in games before, it's sticking to the beat and finding a rhythm of how you want to do your actions where it gets really complicated. It's almost like relearning how to play an FPS game. But that's not a bad thing, because once you get the flow down, this game is extremely satisfying to play. With a lot of trial and error, I was starting to get better and better, and soon it became more like second nature to fire off your shots to the beat, reload, and keep a flow going all at the same time. In the preview I'm playing here, there are two difficulties, easy and hard, so this is on the easy mode. They don't make it too hard though, because your level of accuracy doesn't need to be as high as other games. You can see this square in the center, and as long as you're shooting an enemy in that square, you're good to go. As I mentioned at the beginning of this video, this is a roguelike game, so each time you play, the different levels will be randomly generated. Roguelikes are a bit of a mixed bag for me, and that also applies here. Each run, you'll be going through a few different arenas in order to fight enemies and collect coins. There are numerous items, weapons, armor, buffs, abilities that can be found throughout each level, sometimes in chests and also sometimes available for purchase. In my playthroughs, I found that a lot of the time it could be the luck of the draw depending on how well your run would go. Sometimes you could be playing at your very best, you're clearing rooms, you're not taking any damage, but you're just not given the opportunity to even purchase a weapon with the coins you've earned. One thing that I haven't quite figured out is that sometimes when you start a new game, you will have a different modifier on your play. For example, this was Frozen Asgard, which basically makes it so it's like you're running on ice constantly. Normally, if there was some kind of difficulty modifier, I would expect there to be some kind of perk, like extra coins or extra health, but I didn't find that to be the case. It's entirely possible that I'm missing something, but that's what I found to be the case overall. It was a bit frustrating because sometimes I would get the modifier I didn't like, so I would just kind of let myself die and restart, so hopefully I would get a normal run. The preview build that we're playing here contains the first two levels of the game, and each of them end with a pretty cool boss. Initially, I found the boss to be really intimidating. It's really a matter of figuring out the moveset and also making sure you have improved equipment in order to take him out easily. And because it is a roguelike, sometimes you are going to have just awesome guns, awesome stats, awesome abilities, and you'll be able to take certain things out extremely easily. Whereas other times, you might only have a pistol before the boss, and that's going to be really difficult. The final version of the game coming out in September will feature 5 different playable characters. In this build, I had the ability to play as these two. Each character has its own strengths and weaknesses. For example, this second character starts with a revolver instead of the pistol. And overall, I've only scratched the surface of a lot of the different elements of this game. There are numerous different enemy types. There's different abilities like teleporting. There's all kinds of guns. There's a lot here that this game has to offer. So while I've only gone over some of the most important elements of BPM, I want to emphasize that this game was just really fun to play. As I mentioned earlier, there was a bit of a barrier when I first started playing. You know, like I said, you have to relearn how to play in FPS in order to play to the rhythm. But once it clicked for me, it was so much fun. Bullets Per Minute will launch on PC on September 15th. So if you like FPS games or you like rhythm games, I would definitely keep your eye on this one as it gets closer to launch. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to subscribe to us here on Handsome Phantom and also visit us at handsomephantom.com. We'll see you guys next time.